Oh. Why did you stop streaming? Oh, you did.
All right, on the table number one, TV table, Josh Franklin.
All right, we're waiting.
Randy Johnson Jr. Josh Franklin and Randy Johnson, table one.
All right, Bob's Fire Grill, steaks, chicken, and chops, baby. Steaks, chicken, and chops. Dunnigan's Collision Center. It is your right to select the auto body shop that repairs your vehicle. That's what you want to know. Jamerson Auto Sales. Get yourself a used auto from the king of all used car dealers in the Benton area, Billy Jamerson, also sponsor and tournament director. It has got to be Geo's. Geo's, delivering pizza, Italian beef, gyros, and more. Gale's Auto Body Repair. You want to go fishing? Get your car repaired instead. And then get some bait. I love Gale Murray. Guess who's up next? Josh Franklin versus Randy Johnson Jr. This is the kind of battle from the winner's bracket that we've been waiting for. Josh Franklin, Randy Johnson Jr., two of the greats, two of the players to beat, two of the high takers in the Calcutta player auction. Who knows what I was talking about? Uh-oh. Why did you stop streaming? Oh, you did.
All right, on the table number one, TV table, Josh Franklin.
All right, we were waiting.
Randy Johnson Jr. Josh Franklin and Randy Johnson, table one.
All right, Bob's Fire Grill, steaks, chicken, and chops, baby. Steaks, chicken, and chops. Dunnigan's Collision Center. It is your right to select the auto body shop that repairs your vehicle. That's what you want to know. Jamerson Auto Sales. Get yourself a used auto from the king of all used car dealers in the Benton area, Billy Jamerson, also sponsor and tournament director. It has got to be Geo's. Geo's, delivering pizza, Italian beef, gyros, and more. Gale's Auto Body Repair. You want to go fishing? Get your car repaired instead. And then get some bait. I love Gale Murray. Guess who's up next? Josh Franklin versus Randy Johnson Jr. This is the kind of battle from the winner's bracket that we've been waiting for. Josh Franklin, Randy Johnson Jr., two of the greats, two of the players to beat, two of the high takers in the Calcutta player auction. Who knows what I was talking about? We're going to get some warm-up here from all the players. Let them get used to the TV table. And then we're going to come back. I'm going to take a little break here. I'll be back once the action starts. This is the OnQ Broadcast Network. Okay, Crazy Bob is back. Looks like the action is underway. This is the first game. Randy Johnson Jr. got the break. Okay, he's going to have a cut here on the five ball. Want to come off the end rail, maybe with some inside English. Maybe just, he might be able to just follow it and get what he needs. And that's exactly what he does. He's got pretty good speed there. Comes the drawback into having shape on the seven. Now, he might have to knock the nine ball out of the way here so he can get shape on the eight. I'm not exactly sure. He might be able to stun it back behind the nine ball. And that's what he does. All right. Got a pretty good shot here, making this nine ball. And he makes it. Cue ball is safe. That means Josh Franklin draws first blood here on the TV table. This is stream two of the Brew 2's monthly nine ball tournament. This is a $100 buy-in, non-handicap tournament. Race to seven on the winner's side, race to seven on the loser's side. This is winner's side action, Randy Johnson Jr., Josh Franklin, both very tough players. In fact, everybody in the winner's bracket is still, they're all very tough players. We could have multiple matches that deserve to be on the TV table, but we have to spread them around, folks. It's good that we're having a little bit of everybody on here. Let me put my glasses on so I can read some of the comments, talk to you guys a little bit. Fired in there, says James Faircloth. Too late, he already did. David Head says, get him, Josh. Well, Josh got him. Is this the next match, a winner's side match? I just answered that question. Bubba Felton, also known as Mike Felton, Valley Table looks great. I tell you what, they play really great, really fast here. They keep their equipment in good shape. They use fast Simonis cloth, and they use ridgeback rails. These are very nice playing Valley Tables indeed. Not bad with the Calcutta, might be worth a trip. That's what's said by somebody, James Faircloth. Absolutely it might be. We've got people coming in from 2 hours away, sometimes more depending on what it is. We had a Pro-Am tournament here last month that had five or six pros in it, including Justin Bergman, Devin Poteet, Gabe Owen, Alex Olinger, Jonathan Hennessy. I might be forgetting someone, but that's a pretty good stack up for a tournament. Got a lot of good pool going on here in the Southern Illinois area. In fact, the entire tri-state area is a really hotbed area for pool. And I think you're going to see that in this match. All right, the two ball goes on the side to draw back for that three ball. This is the OnCue Broadcast Network. You've got Crazy Bob here broadcasting. We've got Pat Akers, the sheriff, sitting here next to me, working on things like brackets and scoring and all that kind of thing. Kind of the man behind the curtain, as it were. Let's see if he can get over here for this four ball. That's a really good shot. Now this one, I'm not sure exactly what he's going to do. He's probably just going to draw back for it. He's got a little bit of ability to use the rail first here to draw back and be able to get a little bit closer angle. That's exactly what he does. Gives himself enough angle to come around off the, I guess it's a side rail as you're looking to it now. It's the end rail, I guess, for him. Josh Franklin's coming out shooting. We're not seeing any evidence of nerves here. I think this is the first time I've seen him on the TV table. Like to make sure and shout out to all his friends to go ahead and share this so the rest of his friends can see this. Pat Fisher says, I think you're going to see Josh, a lot of Josh. Well, I tell you what, we're seeing a lot of Josh right now. He's shooting real well. Go ahead and share that with your friends here. Let your, make sure he gets a chance to get that spread out in his inner circle. Leah Brighurst asks, what's the winner's prize? Well, it's a $100 buy-in tournament with 25 players, so that's $2,500 in the prize pool. Plus, there's about another $2,000 in the player auction. That's going to be a 2-0 Josh Franklin. So, you guess a little under half of that if it's going to be in the winner's bracket or for the winner of this tournament. So it's a pretty good payday regardless. This way it gets over a little bit faster. We get top, real top opponents come. They're coming as far away from as Owensboro. They're coming from Paducah, Kentucky. They're coming from Flora, Illinois. They're coming from all over the place to get into this tournament. It's a great little tournament and a great little bar here in Benton, Illinois. This is the OnQ Broadcast Network. Randy Johnson here with the break. Franklin. Got a little update there of the scoreboard. All right. Randy Johnson gets one to drop, and he's got a really good look here at this one ball. Now let's see what he does to go ahead and get this ball, this cue ball lined up for the next shot. He's going to come up underneath the two, leaving it for a long shot down in the bottom left corner pocket on your screen. Little stop shot here will give him enough angle to work with on the three ball next. Now Randy Johnson Jr. is one hell of a shot. Him and Kyle Hargis play a lot together. Now he's going to come here with a little bit of inside English to come get shape on this four ball. He might have gone a little far, which might make it a little tweener shot here. Guessing he's going to probably cut back to the side pocket, but man, that's a little further than he wanted. Putting a lot of spin on that to kill it off the end rail, and that's going to give him shapes on the five ball. A little bit of a back cut here, but he wants to come to that side, so he wants to be on that side of that ball. If he stuns across over here to the three, rail first, I think he's going to be really happy with this. He could just follow it up for the eight ball. All right, Randy's shooting pretty good here. He hasn't had much opportunity in the first couple of games. He's left himself pretty straight on this, but like we said a number of times, you can do a lot of work with these corner pockets. And that he does. That was a lot more than I expected at that angle, actually. Really nice out by Randy Johnson Jr. That makes it 2-1. We say it's up next, but it's up now. This is Randy Johnson versus Josh Franklin. All right, Josh Franklin is here, racking him up. Great match so far, Michael Spurgeon says. Keep it up, guys. Did Bo Fettis play this tournament? Heard he plays Jam Up. I do not know about Bo Fettis. I did not see his name in the list. Did not hear him in the stuff, but you might want to let him know about the tournament. We have it once a month. You can contact Billy Jamerson to get signed up for it. It's in Benton, Illinois, here at the Brew 2 Bar. It used to be called the Train Wreck. Probably find both online. Brad Ogburn says, go Jelly. Pat Fisher says, I think you're going to see Josh. A lot of Josh. And that's exactly what we're watching right now. I answered that. Dennis Fowler asks, where is this game being played at? This is beautiful Benton, Illinois at Brew 2 Bar. Brought to you by Dunnigan's Collision Center. Bonfire Grill. Gail Murray at Gail's Auto Repair and Bait Shop. All right, he's going to be a little bit frustrated with this two ball. He doesn't really I don't know if it goes past the five. Does this go past the five, Pat? Looks like it might. It's close. Can you tell from the angle you're sitting at? We've got some deep conversation here up in the broadcast booth. All right, he's looking to see if it gets past this five. I'm not sure it does. It's hard to say. Looks like he's going to come up with a safety here. He's going to show Josh Franklin the ball. My guess is we're going to see a safety here. My guess is he's going to just a little bit left English. A low stop shot here, maybe. Maybe the other angle will give us a better feel of what he's going to do. No, not really. That's about the best. I think he just he could thin the ball and run the cue ball around the table, but I think he's just going to stop the cue ball right there, try to get underneath the nine, and then send the two ball up table, which is exactly what he does. And I think he's going to be really happy with the result. That's some excellent pool right here. Let's see. What rules do we go by, TAP or APA? Well, we go by neither. Basically, this is just basic nine-ball rules. Push-out is used. This is a Dennis Fowler question here on the comments. So if you have any questions for the commentators or just me, since I'm the only commentator right now, nine on the break does not count anywhere, so there's no snapping of the nine. I should point out that this, since we use BCA rules, the on-cue Billiards runs a BCA pool league, and we do tend to standardize around those rules. But we do make it so that the nine ball does not count on the break. This is an alternating break tournament, race to seven in the winners, race to seven in the losers. All right, does he get the spin to get it? He gets a hold of the ball. Ooh, I can't tell. He can see the whole ball, but I'm not sure if he's got enough to make it. It probably does. He's fired up. Oh, shaking. All right, if you notice that we've got a little bit of bass in the house, it's shaking our camera a little bit. Kind of like driving with a big old system in your car, the mirror behind you. All right, I think he's feeling pretty confident about this three ball going in the side pocket. From this angle, it's hard to tell how frozen up it is, but it looks like it's got far enough to go. This angle is going to give you a little bit better feel. I'll have to use some back English to do it, which might make it a little less... A little less accurate here. Hope I answered your question there, Dennis Fowler. For answering your question, can you do me a favor and share this? All right, I say he was pretty confident, but I tell you what, he's not going to make the shot, and he's going to give Randy Johnson Jr. a look at this three ball. And the three ball's going to come now, or the cue ball's going to come naturally off the side rail. So he's going to have to look at both if he can make the shot. It is off the rail. Anytime you give your opponent distance and being on a rail, it makes it a tougher shot. Is it ball in hand if you foul? Absolutely, Dennis. It's basically standard nine ball rules that way. There's no three foul rule in effect. And he just misses that to the end rail side. And he's going to get another stab at a thin cut in the side because the eight ball is blocking up the corner pocket here. That's leaving a wide open table. And a guy who's shooting at this level is really dangerous here. This could put him up to a 3-1 lead if he can get out. I have no idea. Is that Chris? Who was that? That's what I thought it was. All right. Come off the end rail, back up for the eight ball. He gives himself enough angle to come across table for the nine. Unless he does wants to try to hold it. I think he comes across table on this. Yeah, Chris Esker. And that's exactly what he does. Get a little bounce off of that side rail, and that leaves him pretty good for the nine ball. I believe this is going to be 3-1 to Josh Franklin. He makes that center pocket. All right, this is Randy Johnson Jr., racking and breaking for himself. He's down to 1-3.
Table three, Rick Rankin, Chris Esker. Chris Esker, Rick Rankin, table three.
I haven't even seen Rick Rankin here today.
Been here all day. I mean, he's kind of short, so sometimes it's hard to see.
Yeah, it's true.
So I told him in the auction, I was yelling for him. I said, Rick, go to chair and wave your arm.
All right, looks like you got the break here. If we could get the big scoreboard out of the way, we'd have something. All right, Randy Johnson Jr. gets the break. He can see the one, but I don't know that he can do a lot with it. So we're going to probably see some safety play here. Brian Gray says, if my baby girl can see this, this is for you, baby. Daddy loves you so much. I don't know who you're talking to, but you better share this video with her so she can see it. Share it with everybody. David James, DJ in the house, sharing and caring with the OnQ Broadcast Network. This is Crazy Bob. Is it alternate breaks or winter breaks? It is alternate break, Lee Brighurst. We got Patrick McPherson jumping in, watching some pool here on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. This is the OnQ Broadcast Network Benton Brew $200 entry nine-ball tournament. These things come monthly at you. They got little variations from the time to time, but you need to talk to Billy Jamerson if you want to get in. $100 buy-in. The question now, is this the winner's side? It absolutely is the winner's side, Blaine. Hard to tell what your first name is, Blaine. Is it Timothy? Blaine? Patrick? Murphy? The fourth? You got a lot of names, guy. But I'm the third. I know how that goes. All right. This looks like some safety play, I'm assuming. Is this the final round? Henry Balcom asks. This is nowhere near the final round. We're going to have pool broadcasting here going in late into the night. We're a little over halfway done with the tournament at this point. And it just keeps getting better. There are a lot of great matches being played here. We want to thank you guys for joining us here today. He gets a good hit on that kick shot. But the result is going to be a very good-looking table for Josh Franklin. I don't see anything that's really that difficult. I mean, maybe going from the 4 to the 5, I think, is going to be the toughest shot here. But since the 5 goes in over the top left-hand corner, I think he might not have too much difficulty on there. I think he wanted to draw that back a little bit more. But he can come off the rail, draw, come off the rail, come back over towards the 4 ball in the bottom pocket on your screen, the bottom side pocket. That's what he does. Now, we might just see a little dink here to come back up to get the 5 ball into the top left-hand corner that I was talking about. So this is kind of a touch shot on these kind of fast tables, so we're going to see how he does that. And he has some excellent ball speed on that. All right, we got a lot of people out here watching this, let me tell you. Keep on sharing it. Let's see what we got. He hits center pocket. This is getting to be a connect the dots out for Josh Franklin. Getting to a commanding 4-1 lead if he can get this open table out. The way Josh is shooting, this shouldn't be a problem, Michael Spurgeon says. He's shooting great, but I tell you what, once Randy Johnson gets into gear, he's hard to stop. So don't count him out yet, folks. How many rounds are there? I don't know how many rounds there are, Marcos, but there's plenty. Basically, it's 25 people, double elimination. So you can probably do the math faster than I can. I'm busy talking, so it's hard to do math and talk at the same time, but I give it my all. He goes 2 rails over here for this 9 ball, and he gets a good shot. It looks like he's going to be conceding the match or conceding the game there to Josh. So Josh does take that commanding 4-1 lead that we were talking about. All right, this is a fantastic view of Josh Franklin racking. We're having some technical difficulty with our other camera, so we're going to stick with this camera angle here for a little bit. Brad Ogburn says 7. I'm assuming that's the race, yes. Pat Fisher's asking, what is Josh racing to? If you see in the bottom left-hand corner of your screen, it says race to 7 in the overlay that we have here. Henry Bacham asks, is this an open tournament? Absolutely. It's open to anybody with $100. And it's a race to 7, non-handicap. So there you go. How many games per match? We don't know how many games. It's just the first to win to win 7 of them. So, what? Oh. Duh, come on, Pat. So, yes, this is a race to 7. It's a race to 7 in both the winner's bracket and the loser's bracket. We've had various different formats here over the months. And from the Pro-Am tournament last month to this tournament, they're all different. But all of them are open to any player. Sometimes we'll have a handicap tournament. Sometimes we'll have something a little different. I'm assuming he's banking this. I'm not exactly sure, to be honest with you. Pat Fisher says, I can't see anything but chat. It's on the, it's actually on the bottom part. I think you could swipe the chat away from it if you're on a phone. Man, that's a nice shot if he got there on the. All right, it looks like the camera's back up and working on this side. He gets the bank here. Does he get shape, or is it going to go into the side pocket? Oh, he stays alive just barely. right, we got a lot of different people out there watching our stream for the first time. If you're a first-time viewer, go ahead and check out the On Cue Billiards page and like it. This is kind of a gut check shot for the seven ball. So we're going to go ahead and bring Mickey Hammond back into the broadcast booth to get some extra commentary for these matches.
What we got going here? Josh, I tell you, the kid's the real deal.
This kid can play now. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, and he got a heck of a roll.
He got a heck of a break there. I mean, yeah, that's one of those things that the
Josh plays out of the Pekin area. He's from Pekin, Peoria.
So, yeah, people are coming from a good distance to play, aren't they?
Yeah, I think he may be one of Bobby McGrath's proteges. Bobby's helped him a lot.
Bobby was asking about him a little bit earlier on the comments.
Yeah, he goes by Jelly.
There you go. Jelly
and
it is.
And we know why.
Yeah.
We just seen the nine ball.
Exactly. All right, Josh Franklin needs two. Randy Johnson Jr. He's breaking right now, needs a full six to get back in this and win this match. All right, he breaks dry, leaves a sight line on this one ball. Michael Spurgeon says, I was there to watch Hammond walk through the A division at the Indiana State VNEA last year. He didn't save the VNEA, but since I was there as well, I was sure it was VNEA.
That was a VNEA. I was there.
You were there?
I was there.
I was there.
I remember that.
I got a picture of you wearing my hat.
Yeah, you're right. I got that picture, too.
Not bad. Robert McClellan, he says, wow.
It was a pretty fun tournament, really. My first time ever being at Indiana State VNEA.
Yeah. Worked out better than Indiana State APA, did it?
Yeah. Well, they told me that I was going to come in as a B player because I'd never played. But
yeah.
But then they switched it and made me play in the A division.
So you just rolled over it.
I guess I did.
You got to do what you got to do. Sometimes you got to make lemons out of lemonade. I think it's backwards, isn't it?
Hey, I did go to the hill twice with somebody.
There you go.
So it wasn't a total walkthrough.
Oh, he takes the shot at the nine. Just misses it. Now, because of where this two ball is, it's going to leave a fairly open table there for Randy. But Randy hasn't gotten on the table enough to kind of get into his
groove.
Yeah,
he ain't got a chance to get any momentum going. Josh is playing well and hiding well. And
sometimes when you don't get a chance to get into a rhythm, that's the kind of shot that happens.
You're right. He just pushed that ball right to the rail. It does happen.
Josh is the defending New Year's 9-foot nine-ball champion in Peoria. The tournament is actually this Saturday and Sunday.
They call it the New Year's tournament, but it's on February the 3rd. It used to be called Dave's Good Time Billiards. It's called the Rack and Cue or something now.
Might be Chinese New Year.
Maybe.
Gung Hei Fat Choi.
Chris Brown, yes, Boucher is in this. He hasn't lost yet. He's in the final eight of the winner's side. Yeah, I played at Dave's Good Time Beards a few times. They got a lot of gold crowns and some bar boxes.
This right here is looking like a combo shot. That's going to put Josh Franklin first on the hill. One, Randy Johnson. Six, Josh Franklin. This is the OnCube Broadcast Network. I think this is the first time we've had Josh Franklin on the TV table, isn't it?
Tonight, yes.
Have we had him in the past?
We had him a month ago in the Pro-Am. He played Hennessy right here.
Oh, okay.
He had Hennessy down 7-2.
I was busy swimming in the ocean.
He was in Belize. Yeah, racks on the rocks.
I did get to see some of that tournament, but I didn't get to watch all of it. Belizean internet's a little bit... iffy sometimes, we'll say.
Yeah, he had Hennessy down 7-2, and Hennessy ended up running four racks on him. Now, and Hennessy really slowed his game down, which Josh is young. He likes to shoot, you know.
Yeah, he likes to run around the table and hit balls in the hole quickly, doesn't he?
Yes.
Racks on the rocks is the new game. Speaking of on the rocks, somebody sent me some bourbon.
Yeah, that's what it's called now, Racks on the Rocks, the old Dave Time, Good Time Billiards.
Oh, that's what the name of the place is?
Yeah. Well, he makes the nine on a break, which we know that don't count. He can see the one ball but don't have a direct clear path to a pocket.
So was that the only ball that went down?
I believe so.
No, there's missing. There's one more ball missing. So.
Oh, yeah, you're right. There's looks like we're missing the four ball.
But if you make just the nine ball, what happens from there, Mickey?
What's that?
If you make just the nine ball, you just spot it up and keep shooting?
It's still your shot, yeah.
What if it hooks you really bad? I mean, I guess that's why you can push.
Yeah, yeah. The push is viable. And,
you know, but who's won the most? Bob has, right?
That's right.
Tell me old Bob used to, back in the day, Bob Randall's right.
Yeah, I get him
so
every time.
Chris opts to play a safety, or Josh plays a safety, and what a beautiful safety it was.
I tell you what, it's about as nice as you'd ever want or need.
He thinned to one ball and came two rails around. Put him behind that 5-9, or 3-9.
All right, so let's see what he comes up with. Do want to thank everybody for sharing this. Chris says he played Josh in that tournament. Well, I tell you what, how'd you do against Josh? That's the question. I don't make it up here to broadcast every one of these tournaments.
I could definitely go back to the bracket and see. So,
I don't get to see all of these matches necessarily. I mean, I can watch him at home just like you guys as well, but so I haven't got a chance to see his game a lot, but I tell you what, I'm really impressed with what I'm seeing tonight.
He plays well. Nothing crazy, just he plays and makes the balls, gets the leaves. That was a good shot.
I mean, that's
shot.
A hell of a shot just good. To get a good
that
hit.
That was a great
and
hit.
And he almost
Randy.
Drains it in that corner pocket.
Chris beat Josh 7-4.
Well, there you go, Chris. Did we forget to ask you why you're not here today?
He says he's working or something. Yeah, I remember he played him early in the tournament, and Josh just fought back through. And
I think we went over this earlier in the day. But it's good to see you out here when you get out here. Did you make it down to Derby this year? I know I saw you there last year. Anthony Reed says, what's the deal with the combo into the nine, but the nine on the break isn't to win?
Well, it's two different shots, I guess.
One is absolutely a skill shot, and one is very much a luck shot that you're trying to take. With shorter races into race to seven, I believe that's why you're taking the nine on the break out of the equation.
Now, Josh did get lucky on a nine ball last game.
He did? Yep. And they could change it to call nine or something like that, but that's a pretty standard nine ball rule.
It is. I prefer call nine, but.
Yeah. But if you're going to do that, just play 10 ball. Why not? Make it hard. I'm fine with either way. What do you think he might do? You think he might do this?
Well, he's going to try to thin off the seven and come around. And he did.
Woo, I thought that was going to be risky. And I tell you what, he's going to get paid well for it, I think. As long as he can see the full four.
Yeah, he'll come two rails for a leave on the six here.
Or the five. Okay. Oh, yeah, I thought that was the four. That's the seven ball.
Yeah, he'll try to get two rails on the six here.
Sometimes it looks a little bit different color there.
It does.
In fact, that's why they changed the color of the balls here for some TV table. One of our cameras here in our small setup is one that is a little bit it's got worse color correction than the other, so
don't remember.
Sometimes it's hard to see from that angle. All right, he ends up scratching in the bottom left-hand corner. That's going to get Randy Johnson Jr. a chance to get things going here in the winner's bracket of the Benton Brew $200 entry nine-ball tournament. A nice cut into the corner pocket. I think he's going to end up having pretty good shape here on the 10 or the 8. My guess is he's going to take that down to the bottom corner pocket and come over for the 9. He makes that look easy. Leaves himself straight in for the 9. I'm guessing Randy's going to go ahead and get his second game here. That he does. This is the AllQ Broadcast Network, brought to you by Jameson Auto Sales. Also brought to you by La Fiesta Authentic Mexican Grill. It's on 100 S Jackson Street.
Gene Lauderdale, Robert Marino.
721 West Washington is Tequila's Mexican Restaurant. The Mexican restaurants here are supporting Pool in the Benton area. So are the pizza joints, and that's Joe's Pizza and Pasta. All right, let's get back to the action. This is Randy Johnson Jr. with a chance to break and get back into this match with Josh Franklin on the hill.
Randy comes up dry.
Yeah, nothing's going to go down here, and Josh is going to have a good look at this one ball. Where the two ball is a little tough. He might be able to back cut it and come down for it there.
Josh has got a great option. He can go for this and try to get on the short side of the two, or he can play a hell of a safety here too.
I think I'm not exactly sure what he's doing. He's looking like he was jacking up to draw that ball.
I mean, he could thin that one and put that two ball in the woods.
It looks like he might be sending that one ball back in underneath this ball. It's hard to say. He's thinking about it.
Yeah.
The only problem with that shot is if it squirts out after it, then he might have a big pocket looking at that corner pocket. He wants to keep pressure on Randy Johnson. That's what he's doing. He's rolling up into these balls, getting behind the nine ball there. It's not going to be hard for him to make contact on this ball, but it's going to be difficult to know exactly where the cue ball is going to come off of it. If he gets it good and thick, he's probably going to leave him tough in the weeds there. I got to hear a little bit of myself there on the broadcast.
A little bit.
Oh, I'm hearing it again a little bit.
Oh, got a little bit on it, don't we?
All right, now he gets a good hit, but the problem is that leaves this one ball in the open. Now, what is he going to do with this one ball? He could stun back and get kind of come back for that same cluster of balls for a safe if he wants, or he could try to go for maybe a bank stun to get on the two. What do you think?
Well, looks like he's trying to cut it in the side.
Well, it was risky for sure.
I mean, he wouldn't have scratched if he'd have made it, but he didn't make it.
Isn't that the way of the world? In fact, it might have come back off that end rail and come back up table. Look like
yeah, that's
soft.
What he's trying to do, just come off the end rail and back down for the two ball in this bottom left corner, what we're looking at.
I think it was going to be a little slow for that, but then again, if he made the ball, that must have, it makes everything different.
Yeah, because he would hit it thinner, which would have increased his speed.
Absolutely. It would impart less of the energy into the actual object ball and still stick with the cue ball to come back down off the rail a little bit faster.
Exactly.
Every once in a while, I like to show off my scientific side. All right. Anybody got any questions for us? Go ahead and send us some information in here. He's going to have a pretty good shot here at this one into the corner pocket, and that's going to get him on the two ball, but my feeling is I'd probably take a safe here.
Two ball goes in this bottom right corner. The cue ball naturally travels.
You think it goes straight?
Yeah, it'd go straight between the 7 and 5.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that it got through there.
Just naturally two rails around for the three.
I tell you what, I might need to open my eyes or something or get some soap to wash them out with because I couldn't see that. Maybe I should clean my glasses. That might be the idea that's going on here. I'm seeing ghosts. I thought they were ghosts, but it's just dirt on my glasses. Words of wisdom coming in from the peanut gallery, letting me know that I can't see because of my glasses.
Randy hit that little short. End up putting him behind a six ball.
We'll put Mindy to work here cleaning my glasses. Now I can't see anything. What's going on, Mickey?
Well, we're playing pool. First off.
This is a $100 buy-in, I heard.
Randy actually shot a shot here and came up short for his leave on the four ball.
Then he got... What's that? No, I don't need that shit in my eyes. I don't need no shit in my eyes. He gets the jump, but he doesn't get the ball to go down.
No, and he left Josh a pretty routine out now.
Yeah, this is going to be an out that he's going to like. And since he only needs one game, this is nerve-wracking when you're sitting on the rail watching at this point, isn't it? We've all been there, haven't we?
We definitely have.
I've never been in the winner's bracket, so.
Well, you started there.
Oh, I don't know. I don't think they even let me start in the winner's bracket. I lose to the bye in the first round. I've played in this tournament one time, and I got to the second round. Basically, it's a double elimination tournament, so I got to play twice.
Right.
Which is fun. All right.
Got a little more angle than he wanted here. You can't see that because you ain't got no glasses on.
And he's a little close to that nine ball, but I think he's got enough forward. He can draw back off of this spin to get to the
eight. Yeah, okay.
And he's really going to be happy with that shot. Draw back just a little bit, and he's going to have perfect on the nine.
Oh, yeah.
All right, not bad commentating by a guy who can't see. All right, the glasses are back, and they're cleaner than ever. I just put a big smudge on them with my fan, though.
Well, we got Josh ran away with a smooth 7-2 victory over another great player, Randy Johnson Jr.
I tell you what, he is playing strong. He is going to be someone to reckon with.
7-2.
All right, the final score, Josh Franklin 7, Randy Johnson Jr. 2. We're going to go find you another great match here at the Brew 2 monthly tournament. Kyle Hargis is chomping at the bit trying to get in on the TV table. We've got a number of previous champions here who have yet to play on the big table.
All right, on the stream table we got Wayne the Hurricane Jenkins and Kyle Hargis.
All right. This is actually what we were looking for.
The
next match.
Kyle's been waiting on a rematch on this street table against Wayne for quite a while now, so he gets his chance.
All right, now that we got some of the... stuff out of the way, we're going to put you some ads while we get the scores. What? I ain't got nothing.
Last time I seen it, I gave it to you.
I ain't got nothing. Oh, here it is.
So you got it.
All right. Up next, Wayne the Hurricane Jenkins versus Kyle Hargis. Let me tell you a little about Tequila's Mexican restaurant. They've got authentic Mexican food. Look at the pictures. Look at the sombreros. It's a beautiful thing, this Tequila's Mexican restaurant. Joe's Pizza and Pasta. You can't see any pizza and pasta in there, but you can see a hell of a lot of chairs. That means they're serving a lot of pizza and pasta. Joe's Pizza and Pasta. Bonfire Grill. Steaks, chicken, chops, sandwiches, and more. Those fries are made of potatoes, folks. They're made of potatoes. Dunnigan's Collision Center. We want you to know, in the event of an accident, it is your right to select the auto body shop that repairs your vehicle. Dunnigan's Collision Center. They do more. Jamerson Auto Sales. It's your used car dealer in Benton. Billy Jamerson at 618-927-1302. That's your man. Gio's Pizza. We've been eating Gio's Pizza until we're sick. God, I love it. It has to be Gio's. Gale's Auto Repair. When you need to go fishing and get your car repaired, Gale Murray's the guy to talk to. 618-279-7800. La Fiesta Authentic Mexican Grill. They make authentic Mexican food on the grill. What a job. All right, now we're going to have up next Wayne Hurricane Jenkins versus Kyle Hargis in a matchup of two previous winners of this tournament. It doesn't get any better than this, folks. These are some of the greatest pool players in the tri-state area. Matching off, we've got Kentucky versus Illinois. We've got older gentlemen versus younger gentlemen. We've got a methodical player versus a field player. This is what you've come to see. All right, this is the OnQ Broadcast Network starring the best players in all of the tri-state area. With yours truly, Crazy Bob, on the mic.
Table four, Jake Embry and Chris Austin. Chris Austin, Jake Embry, table number four.
I don't know if you guys can hear me when that goes off, so I just kind of stop talking when it happens. I'm not used to stop talking. That was a nice match. That's what Michael Spurgeon says. Jake Williams says 11, question mark. I'm guessing he's asking what the race is. The race is to 7. If you see the little on-cue broadcasting logo there on the main page,